Typical use cases for this service are in scenarios where the ECU is getting programmed with a new software. Usually the transmission and reception of the ECU is disconnected before the reprogramming starts. In the last video, we had a look into details of Security Access Service, Service 27. Let's have a look into the next diagnostic service, that's Communication Control Service, Service 28. Before we dive in, let's first understand the purpose of this service. Communication Control Service, as the name implies, is used to control communication of the ECU in the network. The service is used to switch on or off the transmission or reception of certain messages of the ECU. Typical use cases for this service are in scenarios where the ECU is getting programmed with a new software. Usually the transmission and reception of the ECU is disconnected before the reprogramming starts. Also at workstations or garage where the ECU is investigated for an issue or so, the service is used to ensure isolation of the ECU from the network. With this understanding, let's dive into the request definition of the service. Firstly, we have the Communication Control Request SID, which maps to value 28. Then we have the subfunction parameter control type of the service. Then we have the communication type parameter followed by node identification number, that's higher and lower bytes. The value specified in the control type parameter has influence on the communication type parameter. The list of values supported for control types are value 0, which maps to enable RX and TX. This value indicates that the reception and transmission of the messages shall be enabled for the specified communication type. Next, we have value 1, which maps to enable RX and disable TX. This value indicates that the reception shall be enabled, but the transmission shall be disabled for the specified communication type. Next, we have value 2, disable RX and enable TX. Can you guess what would this mean? Yes, you're right. This value indicates that the reception shall be disabled while the transmission shall be enabled for the specified communication type. Then we have value 3, which maps to disable RX and TX. This value indicates that the reception and transmission of messages shall be disabled for the specified communication type. Next two values are quite interesting. Value 4, which is enabled RX and disabled TX with enhanced address information. This value indicates that the address bus master shall switch the related sub bus segment to the diagnostic only scheduling mode. Then we have value 5, which maps to enabled RX TX with enhanced address information. This value indicates that the address bus master shall switch the related sub bus segment to the application scheduling mode. The range of values from 6 to 3F and 7F are ISO SAE reserved. Value range from 40 to 5F are mapped to vehicle's manufacturer specific range. Then we have value range from 60 to 7E, which is mapped to system supplier specific range. Let's now look into the communication type parameter. This parameter is used to refer the kind of communication to be controlled. Multiple communication type can be controlled at the same time as the control is bit encoded. Following are the values supported by bit 0 to 1. Value 0, which maps to ISO SAE reserved. Value 1, which maps to normal communication message. This value refers all the application related communications. Value 2, which maps to network management communication message. This value, as the name implies, refers to all the network management related communications. And then we have value 3, which is a combination of value 1 and 2, that's network management communication message and normal communication message. So it refers to all the network management related communication and application related communications. Let's go to the next bits, that's bit 2 to 3, which are reserved for ISO SAE for future use, followed by bit 4 to 7, which can map to these values. Value 0, which maps to disable enable specified communication type. This value shall disable or enable all the application or network management or both messages as specified by bit 0 to 1. Then we have value 1 to E. This value shall be mapped to disable or enable specific subset identified by the subnetwork number. This value shall only disable or enable specific subnetwork connected to the received node identified by the subnetwork number. Then we have value F, which maps to disable or enable network on which request is received. This value shall disable or enable the message through which the communication control request is received. And lastly, we have the node identification parameter. This parameter is used to identify a node on a subnetwork somewhere in the vehicle. The parameter is only required if the subfunction parameter control type is set to 04 or 05. Let's look into the positive response. Positive response contains communication control response SID, that's 68, and subfunction control type, which echoes bit 6 to 0 of the subfunction parameter from the request message. Now let's have a look into the NRC supported by this service. NRC 12, which is subfunction not supported. This NRC shall be sent if the subfunction parameter is not supported. NRC 13, which is incorrect message length or invalid format. This NRC shall be sent if the length of the message is wrong. NRC 22, which is condition not correct. This NRC shall be sent when the server is in a critical normal mode activity and therefore cannot disable or enable the requested communication type. And lastly, NRC 31, which is request out of range. The server shall use this negative response if it detects an error in the communication type or node identification number parameter. Now let's look into some examples. Let's consider a situation where this client has to disable TX message, in particular the network management messages. Then the request shall be sent as follows. We'll have the communication control request SID, which is set to 28. Then we have the control type, which shall be set to 1, that is enable RX and disable TX, and communication type, which shall be set to 2, that is network management, following which the network management messages shall be disabled and the response shall be as follows. Communication control response SID shall be set to 68 and control type which shall be set to 1. Let's consider another scenario where the diagnostic only scheduling mode needs to be activated on sub-bus segment by the bus master addressed by 0A. Then the request shall be sent as follows. As usual, the communication control request SID shall be set to 28. Control type shall be set to 4, that is enable RX and disable TX with enhanced address information. Communication type shall be set to 1, that is normal message, and node identification number set to 0A. Following which, the diagnostic only scheduling mode shall be activated on the sub-bus segment and the response from the bus master shall be as follows. The communication control response SID shall be set to 68 and the control type shall be set to 4. With this, we have covered the communication control service 28 in detail. In upcoming session, we'll have a look into tester present service 3E. Thank you.